me.
Le Val, me le bavi. Marie. Aimé the Mac.
When our blessed Lord said this third word from the cross, "Behold thy mother," who is he speaking to? Was it just John the Apostle? In one way, yes. Our blessed Lord said to John, "Behold thy mother," because he knew that John needed Mary to be intimately involved in his life going forward as a spiritual mother if John was to become the great Saint John. And so Christ gave John this gift of his mother. And what was his response? What was John's response to this? The gospel tells us, "And from that hour, the disciple took her into his own home." The Greek text of that verb, to take her into his own home, suggests a far deeper meaning than simply John bringing Mary into his physical home or taking care of her. No, the Greek word actually means that John received Mary into his life. He brought her intimately into his heart. And as a result, we know that John became the great Saint John the Evangelist. But there's more. One of the reasons Saint John the Evangelist did not use his name, but rather the title, the Beloved Disciple, was to send a clear message to you and to me that our blessed Lord's words from the cross, "Behold thy mother," is intended for every single one of us. Anyone who desires to be the beloved disciple, anyone who desires to follow Christ, will find themselves there on Calvary, standing beside Mary and hearing the same words, "Behold thy mother." The first beloved disciple's response was to fully take Mary into his life and receive her completely into his heart, to allow her to be intimately involved in everything that he was doing. What is our response? If we truly desire to be the beloved disciple and to become the great saints that Jesus wants us to be, we too must fully receive Mary into our life. We must take her intimately into everything that's happening into our life. Allow her to be our spiritual mother. And if we do so, the gospel passage will be fulfilled that we too will become great saints. God love you.